Good evening, America, and welcome to Most Wanted. Up to 716 captures to date. Tonight, we're in pursuit of most wanted individuals of another sort, specifically family, friends, loved ones. We know you're out there somewhere. For this missing persons file, we go to Seattle, where we have a Mr. John Doe by satellite. Mr. Doe, if you would, tell us your story.
My story. As it happens, I don't seem to have a story. I don't know who I am or who I was before. You see, a few months ago, I woke up to discover I had no memory of anything. My name, where I came from, if I have a family, parents.
So you're hoping that by appearing here tonight, somebody, anybody out there, might recognize you and hold the key to your identity.
That's right, John.
Do you have any clues whatsoever, anything to go on?
Well, there's this song, My Funny Valentine by Rodgers and Hart. It seems to mean something. And this, it's a picture of a woman who called out to me on the ferry here in Seattle. She was wearing a turquoise scarf and she called me Tommy. Beyond that, nothing.
There you have it, America. You've seen his face, heard his story. Are you out there? Most wanted. Family, friends, loved ones. This man needs your help to answer the question, who is John Doe?
Residents live on the upstairs floors. Old bird in 13B said her cat likes to prowl the building going in and out of windows.
Mm-hmm.
Came home with a finger.
Ugh. Yeah, I hate cats.
Yeah, well, I did a door-to-door, stumbled on him. Just look at that. Last thing he saw must have been the devil himself. Not a scratch on him, but this. Guess Garfield got tired of Fiorina.
Hey, save the wisecracks, Rosie. This is Patch McComber, PI, small time, usually staking out cheating husbands with him in Nolta. So what's the upside of this?
A lot of question marks. So far, no prints, no fibers, no nothing. Dealing with somebody top notch.
That's not his usual clientele. Patch and I used to hit the cocktail circuit. Let me ask you something, Rosie.
What's that?
What do you get when you cross 10 late night shots of Jameson with a half dozen Irish drinking songs?
You got me.
Private eye? That ain't that private. Somebody. Please.
You're a regular Where's Waldo, you know that? All I gotta do is show up at a crime scene, sooner or later I find you.
Grocery store. Here. My God, he tapped my phones. I don't understand.
Join the party. He's logged your every move. A couple weeks at least.
Who is this guy?
Local PI. Better question is who's footing the bill.
And who came to collect?
Somebody's looking for me. All I have to do is ask. Trust me. I'll answer.
Well, whoever they were, they didn't leave a trace. There's no sign of blunt trauma, no indications of poisoning, toxicity.
Great. So he was scared to death.
I'm thinking it's a massive coronary. I just can't put my finger on what induced it. I mean, this guy's in decent enough shape.
No sign of deep vein thrombosis, no skin discoloration.
Well, I've heard of taking your shoes off at work, but your socks, too. Guy didn't even loosen his tie.
Huh. Expression on his face looks to me like the mastoid bone nerve endings have been frozen. Or fried.
Oh, diabolical. You think... Yeah, we got pale raised skin on each dog.
Arborescent leaf-like patterns.
Bingo. But there's no burn marks.
Wouldn't have to be, if it was under 60 cycles.
You two want to come up for air and connect the dots?
This man's been electrocuted. Given the low voltage, I'm guessing he was administered continual electric shocks. Went too far.
Some kind of POW interrogation. McComber wasn't given the answers they wanted.
Well, I'll lay odds the answers they wanted are right in that room.
Well, Mr. Doe, the good news is that somebody out there appears to know you. Bad news is... They happen to be a psychopath.
I wasn't much of an organizer. Only entry, last Wednesday, 10 a.m., Madison P.
639 Madisons in the state of Washington.
Okay, 6 weeks ago, M. Constance, a green L, Pike P.
Pike P, Pike Place, M. Constance, Mount Constance. These are locations.
Madison P. Get your picnic basket, Doe. We're going to the park. Madison Park.
Yes, every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Bored housewives, mostly. But a few budding talents worth mourning. You know what I mean?
When it comes to clandestine meetings, well...
Turns out nobody comes to the park to be witnesses.
Don't be so sure. Notice anything?
Yeah. This guy ain't much of a teacher.
In front of the monument. Ball guy, bow tie.
Looks like Patch, the PI.
Excuse me, when were these started?
Last Wednesday.
Hard to get a make on the trench coat guy.
Got a zoom on this thing?
Might not need one. Look at trench coat's hands. Right finger forms a C in front of his face. And here, right hand's an open palm. Ready to be struck by the left. Could be sign language. Maybe Trenchcoat's deaf. What's he signing?
I don't know, Doe. You expect me to believe a guy like McComber's on the other end, understanding every word?
One way to find out.
You too. Well, that was Patch's wife. You were spot on.
Grandmother recently went deaf, so he took a class with her last year. Good guy, that Patch.
Go. Frank, you know Officer Fitzmaurice. Mm-hmm. Hello. She might be able to help.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm on it.
Based on those paintings and the height of the PI he was meeting with, I got approximate height, age, hair color, trench coat. Three hearing impaired supply stores in Seattle. She's gonna check with owners, ask about patients that fit the description.
I'll get some hearing specialists on the phone, see what we can shake free.
What aren't you telling us?
What do you mean?
Why would somebody do all this? Who is this desperate to get to you?
If I knew, I'd tell you. So. Officer Fitzmaurice ran a check on vendors in the area. Found seven names that fit the man in the painting's physical description. I crossed receipts she gathered for closed captioning devices and TTYS units with local phone company subscriber lists.
You hacked into the phone company? That's illegal.
Call the cops. The file's sharing them over.
Numero uno, a Raymond Edwards. And number two, a Charles Guiteau. No vitals.
Charles Guiteau. He assassinated President James Garfield, July 2nd, 1881. Deaf murderer with a sense of humor.
Okay, doing a reverse trace on the phone number gives us 3724 Simpson Boulevard, Unit 7.
Transient Hotel, Beacon Hill.
I'll call Hayes.
Stella, I don't want anyone else getting hurt on my account.
But I can't just...
You're right. I'll grab him on the way out.
myself out.
A deaf man's TTYS unit.
Getting warmer.
The stains don't match up.
Hello?
Water for my tea.
Who are you?
Touch of honey. Spritz of lemon, if you would. Spoons are on the tray. The tea, dear.
Do you know me?
Once upon a time.
You actually recognize me. This woman in the picture.
Teresa.
Teresa. Who is she? Is this her house?
It would seem so, wouldn't it?
Is it my house? My dog?
You were always my favorite, Thomas. So direct.
Thomas. It's mine.
I imagine you're not unlike a pet from the pound, suddenly called by a brand new name. Getting used to it? John Doe.
Confused. Teresa, where is she?
In due time.
Why not now? Who are you?
Baby steps, Thomas. Sit, please.
Wait, there was a man in a trench coat. I found this address.
I know. If you'll calm down, I'll...
No! Somebody's dead because of me!
Thomas, I urge you to settle down.
Thomas, I can't remember Thomas! Teresa, tell me where she is. Right now.
Your reaction's quite understandable, but I must warn you.
Warn me? What are you talking about? Warn me?
Don't make this ugly.
Calling the police. Come on, Frank. Pick up.
Goodbye, Frank. Thank you. story of your life, it would seem.
What is this place?
Somewhere you can't hurt yourself. It's just temporary. You can leave at any time.
Enough of the riddles. Where am I?
I should think you'd have developed a modicum of patience by now. Now take a seat. You have questions, I have answers. Beginning with your name, Thomas Crowder, son of Henry and Carolyn, born Valentine's Day, 1971, Sweetwater, Idaho. John Doe, this is your life. A farmer's son, an ordinary beginning to an extraordinary future. By five, you were riding horses, milking cows alongside dear old dad. But then one autumn day, the life laid out for you took a dramatic detour. Adolescent progressive white matter disease attacks the brain tissue like a school of piranha. Terminal. After your parents exhausted traditional avenues of medical science, they were contacted by the organization I represent. A consortium of elite scientists and physicians dedicated to the advancement of medical science, unencumbered by the dictates of regulatory agencies. The program, as it was called, enlisted you and six other children suffering the same ailment for an experimental treatment. Four of the children expired from the treatment, while three survived. Yourself, Teresa from Des Moines, and Michael from Baton Rouge. The markings on your chests were courtesy of an implanted device responsible for monitoring pH levels. They were later removed, leaving you with the scar with which you have become so familiar. The years passed, and the program continued to monitor your progress, taking note of a number of unintended side effects. Monochromatic vision, certain unexplained phobias, and a profoundly advanced intellectual development in the cerebral cortex. As you matured in the program, it became clear that the three of you were gifts for desperate times. Imagine, Thomas, the promise of curing terminal disease, ending starvation. We were on the verge of such promise, all because of the accident that was you. Until that day you disappeared, we lost you. More accurately, you lost yourself for 3 years now. We've surmised it to be a kind of fugue state, your brain dipping in and out of self-consciousness, amnesia, apparently another side effect of the treatment. Across the country we searched. Teresa had nearly given up all hope. We all had.
Some kind of experiment.
Don't look at it like that. Look at it as a gift.
Why the secrecy? Why kill someone?
The unfortunate byproduct of an overzealous employee.
You just expect me to sit here for story time, and magically I'm supposed to just accept all of this!
I understand. You have doubts, still more questions. Goes with the territory. I encourage you to do what you do best. You're free to go. Investigate. Find your peace of mind.
Peace of mind? How am I supposed to? Where'd you go? How do I get out of here?
You can hang with the thugs and thieves. a side of beef, but you don't know.
Is that you? Tommy? Lord's sake, son, it's me. Lauren Barker. Don't you recognize me?
Sorry.
You really don't remember me, do you?
No, sir.
My, they were right. Hey, it's okay. It's okay. I know about all of it. What happened? Boy! It sure is hard to believe, seeing you again, eye to eye.
You know about my...
The amnesia. Yeah, your folks told the missus and me all about it. I guess we might should start over. I'm Lauren Barker. I own the property next door. This here, this was, it was your folks' place.
Wait a minute. If you know my parents, where are they? Are they here? What? Please.
You've been gone 3 years. Your father passed not long after you disappeared. Stroke. Caroline, just last summer. I swear she died of a broken heart. You just take your time, son.
I don't remember.
Oh, goodness sakes, Cassie.
He ain't a ghost.
Oh, I'm sorry. I swear I thought you were up with the angels. Somebody slapped me awake.
Somebody slapped me. Mr. and Mrs. Barker.
Hell! You have run naked around this house. It's Cassie and Lauren.
Okay, right. I'm sorry. I'm just drawing a blank. I really don't know what's going on.
Well, you just take it easy, son. You give her a minute.
Her little Cupid. That's what she used to call you. Your mother.
Cupid.
Because you were born on Valentine's Day. I used to rock you to sleep at night, singing My Funny Valentine. Oh, how you love that song.
My Funny Valentine. You... I know that song.
Well, there, you see? Lickety-split, your memory will be up to speed.
Oh, wait a minute. I mentioned that on the TV. Interesting how your recollections match exactly a few things I know about myself.
Well, don't sugarcoat it, son. What are you trying to say?
I'm not sure. There's some strange things happening. It's just... I'm just finding it coincidental, that's all.
Well, I know that you've been to hell and back, Tommy, but I'm too old and too tired to dance with you, so if you're calling me a liar...
Lauren! Cookie jar. Read the back. You made that for your mama when you were 6. Honey, I know you're struggling with a lot. But if you don't believe us, at least believe in this. Those same hands made it from you to her.
I'm sorry. I just...
almost afraid to believe. But don't stop, Wayne. I want to hear more. Everything.
Well, if you want to hear everything, then we might as well start with the time that you marched up Main Street with the town's 4th of July parade and your trousers fell down around your ankles.
Oh, my Lord.
How'd you sleep?
Better than I have in a long time.
Country will do that.
I got a feeling it was more than that.
You feel like making yourself useful? Gotta corral that boy into a pen. Fella's coming by this afternoon to break him.
You don't break him yourself? It's odd, considering 79.9% of horse owners.
Boy, these old bones crack at the sight of a pretty girl. Afraid that horse would break me. Unless.
Horses.
What are you talking about? You used to ride a horse like you were sewn at the hip.
Really?
Ever since your daddy set you on your first pony, Pogo.
Pogo? Mm-hmm.
Pogo.
Pressure on the reins. Hand on the pole.
Once a cowboy, always a cowboy.
Stay loose, son.
Think I changed my mind. Something I definitely don't know.
Oh, hogwash. Tommy Crowder never let a little dust up shine.
Take the boy out of the country, but you can't take the country out of the boy.
Vanilla milkshakes, mama's meatloaf, and let's see. Oh, yeah. Hot dogs.
Hot dogs. I do like hot dogs.
There's something else you liked. Poured your whole beautiful heart into it with every breath.
What?
Teresa. Oh, my. You two. Couple of peas in a pod, best of friends. And as you got older, spending time together in the program, well, more.
More.
Your mama came rushing over one day with news. Said you told her you were going to, going to pop the big question. Wedding bells.
Wedding. Did she say yes?
And she never had a chance to. You disappeared before you ever could ask her. It tore her up inside. She went looking for you. I haven't seen her since.
Well, you just got here. It ain't easy to watch you pulling out so soon.
I just hope that you don't, well, forget again.
This? I'll never forget. I'll be back. I just need to take care of a few things.
Are you sure?
They say that I should be. Well, my mind is capable of so much. I suppose I should be putting it to better use. Guess I have to sort out my old life for my new one.
Sounds right smart.
Homemade. Something to remember us by.
Thank you for everything.
Bye, Tommy. Something to remember us by.
You can hang like a side of beef, but you don't know where to be. You got to know where to be. Just go on.
You.
Frank, I'll explain.
John,
that woman in there, I know her.
Hey, let him go.
John, slow down. What I understand, this is a suicide.
Teresa. No. What have they done to you? Stop! Teresa. It's not the woman on the ferry. Who is that?
What the hell's going on here, John?
It's not Teresa.
Look, I was thinking the worst. Is somebody out here after you?
They're playing with my head.
How could I have believed all of this?
All of what? John, help me to understand.
Frank, you gotta see this. John, you too.
It's not the same. The whole house was a fake.
Here's who's playing with your head. You got your own personal stalker.
This isn't right.
Lieutenant! Found some kind of gizmo.
Let me see that. What the hell is it?
Portable electric chair. PI's last seat.
You want anything? You look like you haven't eaten in a week.
Cupcakes. Homemade cupcakes.
Okay. Property records show the house was leased to a Marjorie Sortland. Ran a check on her. It's not pretty.
Marjorie Sortland.
Yeah, 28-year-old from Spokane. Spent half her life in and out of psych wards. She had a history of this sort of thing. A radio talk show host out of Spokane had a restraining order issued against her. She locked in on him just like she locked in on you.
They switched her with the woman from the ferry. They had Teresa's photograph. Maybe they have her.
John. She's some head case who saw your picture and was off to the races. She hired Patch the PI to find you. When he did, she took him out. Didn't want anyone to know she was coming for you next.
You're not hearing me. I was in that house 2 days ago. They killed her.
They? Who?
I don't know.
I need a little more than that.
There are people out there trying to manipulate me, use me for, I don't know.
Well, what people do, how can I understand if you don't give me more specifics?
There's a picture. I don't know what's happening.
You vanished on us the last 72 hours. Where'd you go?
I was trying to find myself.
Did you?
I found a kid who had a horse named Pogo. Built a treehouse with his father. Liked his mother's meatloaf.
That's you?
I wanted it to be. Maybe so bad I couldn't see the forest for the trees.
But it's...
it's all nothing. I'm sorry. I'm just having a hard time.
Yeah, I had one or two of those myself.
Yeah, my fiance died. Gunshot wound to the chest. He was on the force. You know, wrong place, wrong time. Trying to help somebody. 4 days later, I'm punching back in. I'm on the clock. Like it was nothing. Just like you said. But it was something, you know? It was a problem. Not just for me, but for everybody around me. Almost cost some people their lives. You want my humble 2 cents? Maybe you should take some time, you know, clear your head. Vacation. Doesn't make you any less. Just don't let nothing really turn into something.
Thanks.
According to ancient Greek myth, the phoenix was one with the sun god. Legend has it the bird lived in Arabia, near vast glacial waters. Only one phoenix lived at any given time. When the creature felt its death was imminent, it would construct a looming nest of wood and set it afire. The phoenix was then consumed in flames. The phoenix, my funny Valentine, the woman from the ferry. Are they all connected? All part of something I've yet to understand. I don't know. I don't know if her name's really Teresa. I don't know if she has anything to do with this. But I saw her pictures in color. It has to mean something. I feel it. And the sooner I find her,